I usually enjoy the making of videos better than the original film, and I thought this might be of interest to a few people who like making videos. Well, the object of the thing, what we planned to do, was really just to do one song, and we wanted to do it in 6 different locations, exactly the same song. So we went to this park in Strasbourg called De La Citadelle, where Alan works as a gardener there. And we chose out 6 locations, starting off under the tunnel there. And we recorded the same song, exactly the same, 6 times. We used 2 cameras for each shot, for each recording. And we used a Canon FS100 and a Canon HF100, one high definition, one standard definition. And to record the sound, we used the Zoom H2. La vie s'en vient, la vie s'en va, la vie s'en va. Now, the difficult thing about making a video of a song from 6 different locations and mixing them all together is just hopefully the person who's doing the singing can sing it exactly at the same time and each time. And Alan said to me that he's sung this song so many times that it's imprinted into his brain, so it always comes out the same. And when I had a look at the waveforms afterwards, they were just about spot on. So in the first one, we did the tunnel shot. And then we went up to a little place where Alan's got his sculptures. And we did another take up there. Actually, we did 2 takes there. We did one with Alan standing behind a statue, but we didn't use that one. I didn't like the look of it. And then we did another take down by the river, down by the pond. And for this shot, we used 2 cameras, one concentrating on Alan and the other one concentrating on his reflection in the water. Quite like that effect. So it took us about 4 hours to film all the different takes, and as we were there anyway, then we decided to do a little documentary about his sculpture as well. We rarely met just to do the song, but the documentary thing was just like a bonus. So then we took a few B-rolls, A-rolls, which is just stuff you can put in there. For example, sometimes you might zoom out when you didn't really want to zoom out, or perhaps there's a bad cut or a shaky camera. And then the shaky moment, you can just put a B-roll in there to cover that scene or that cut. So we got all the stuff in the camera finished. We worked till the battery was flat in the camera. And then I came back home and put all the stuff together in the edit program, Magic 17. And then lined it all up with the sound from each one. And then what I did is I took the best soundtrack from those 6 takes we did. And I found that the soundtrack from the top of the hill was the best sounding one. The one in the tunnel was too echoey and would have sounded a little bit strange on the outside shots. So I took the best audio track and then lined all the 6 takes up together. That was 5 takes because I didn't use one. Lined all the 5 takes up in synchronization with each other. And then just cut out the bits that I didn't want to see. So, for example, at the beginning you get the tunnel and then it cuts to the guy on the hill and then it cuts to the lake and then cuts back to the tunnel perhaps. And that's how you do it. And it takes a little while till you get the feeling for it, but it's quite good fun in a way because it trains your mind to thinking more than one direction. You're not just thinking linear, you've got to think sort of sideways or off the page a bit to get it all working correctly. And the other thing as well, it's good for your mind too, is when you're doing the filming, because you've got to think a little bit about the end product and what you are wanting to achieve. So that's quite good training for your brain too, because you're thinking about a lot of different things at once. And also you're thinking about the two camera angles that are going, and you're thinking about the sound. And that's why you always see me doing a clap at the beginning, is to keep everything in sync. Because if you don't have a clap to let yourself know where everything's running from, then you'll never find the point, and you won't get the lips syncing. So I'm quite pleased with how it turned out. It's quite challenging to do a multi-take like that, but it's interesting, and it's like anything, the more you do it, the better you get. But if you don't do it, you'll never get any better. So that's my way of thinking about it. It's all just practice and trying to hone the skills. Well, that's enough from me today. Hope you all have a great day, and this video was of some interest to some people.